In this video tutorial, I am going to show you how to create a quick scripts in using Postman. Scripting in Postman, scripts in a Postman. So here, I'll be going to create the collection. So go to the new, then select the collection. So here the collection is got created. So I will rename the new collection. So here I have given the right script. I'm going to create add folder. Postman script. So let me going to create a request. So before that, I'll go to this site. So here the get API get request is available. So here a post and put. So let me, I'll be going to use the list of users in the get. So this is URL I'm going to use. Here I'll be going to add. Let me rename this thing. So here I selected as a get method. Then this is the URL of the API. So here params I use for p is equal to 2. I am going to sending this request. Yeah, here I got the response body in a JSON format. Then yeah, status code I received here 200 and the status text and the time took for sending the response. So this is the time response and the size of the JSON. So yeah, before that I need to write the script for that. So here I have a pre-request script and a test. So pre-request script is, what is that mean is, so here before a request is sent to the server, so as a pre-request script under the pre-request script. So before that, whenever we are sending before the request, so we need to write the script according to the pre-request script, and we need to run that one. So it will defaultly run before the sending the request to the server. So this is a pre-request script. So after the, once you have received the response from the server, so that time we are going to use the tests. So once the pre-request script is it will first execute, then we have to send the request, then whatever we are getting the response, that will get executed in the response. Whatever we are getting the response in the test, we need to run the test. The test script will get run and as in the JSON format, and request will be the scripts. So pre-request script request will executed before the request is sent, and test script associated with the request will execute after the request is sent. So let me, so here collection will execute in the following order. So if we have any written in the pre-request script, first pre-request script associated with the collection will run prior to every request in the collection. And pre-request script associated with the folder will run prior to every request in the folder. Now, test script associated with the collection will run after every request in the collection. Now, the test script associated with the folder will run after the request in the folder. So, for every request in the collection, the script will always run according to the following hierarchy: collection level script and folder level script, request level script, and the order execution applies in the both pre-request script and test scripts. So this is the we should understand before writing the script for that. So let me go to the here I got the response body as a 200. So for that I need to write the code for that. So what we have to do is, so I need to verify the status code. So this is a command I am using, verify the status code. So pm dot, so for that if you want to write already we have a snippets in the from the right side over here. So if you want to select, if you want to write your own script, that is also fine. So if you want to use, already we have a some snippets, so based on that we need to use, then we can write that. So here the status code, the snippet is available. So when we click on this, so we will get the snippet of the status code. So if you want to change anything in this script, so you can change. So here I will be just changing the verify the status code. So here I got the status code is 200. So let me send this request. So here I got the verify the status code is 200. So similarly we write the code for status text. So once if you find over here, so you will get the snippet as well. So let me check these snippets. So here I have a get an environment variable, global variable. Then so not this one. Yeah, this one I'm going to take. So let me, I will not consider this one. Let me go to the status code name as a string. Let me take this one. So here the status code. Verify the status text is, okay. So here we need to add as a whatever we received in the response body in the text. So I'm just going to add. So let me save this, then send the request. So here I got verify the status text is okay. So let me, I'll be going to add so response time. So let me add the snippet for that. So let me, response time is less than 200. So let me, I will add some time, 40 seconds I have given. So let me send this request. So here I got the verify the response time. So whichever the snippets we need to just verify that. Let me check content type. So here I am using the content type is this one. It is showing some error. Let me, I don't want this one, we'll remove that. So here content type I added. Let me go to header. So I just trying on the application JSON, so no need to do that. So content header is, this is a header we need to add. So then only it will work. So here I added content type. So let me send this request. So here it is working correct. So these are our test scripts for writing the using the Node.js. So similarly, lot more snippets are available. Through snippets we can explore a lot of scripts. So here whatever we are getting the response body, we need to automate the using this response body. So I already added for the snippets for so it's taking snippets. It's very easy to do the code for the Node.js. So this is all that's all in the in this video. So this is the way of writing the very quickly we need to write the script for that. So in the upcoming videos I'll be going to add lot more videos in the upcoming videos. So I'm kindly requesting you to subscribe this channel. So thank you.